What's up internet, welcome back once again. I'm Manish from RebellionWriter.com and today in this Oracle Database tutorial we will learn how to install sample schemas in Oracle Database 12c. And by sample schemas I mean HR, SH, OE and many more. As I have already mentioned in my previous tutorials that in Oracle Database 12c only pluggable databases can have the user data and not the container database. Thus we can install sample schema only in a pluggable database rather than the container database. Therefore today in this tutorial we will create a pluggable database in which we will install all our sample schemas. In case you want to learn how to unlock sample schema in default pluggable database, you can refer to my tutorial 61, link is in the description box. And by default pluggable database, I mean the one which is created either during the installation of Oracle Database 12c or during the creation of a new container database. Okay, now let's move ahead and start the tutorial. As we are going to create a new pluggable database, thus we will use Database Configuration Assistant, also known by the name of DBCA, a utility provided by Oracle itself. I would like to mention here that I am using Oracle Database 12c Enterprise Edition in case you were wondering. To launch DBCA utility, just click and open your start menu and search for DBCA. And then right click on dbca.bat file and choose Run as Administrator. Here on the first screen of the DBCA, you have 5 database operations. Among these, choose the last one which is Manage Pluggable Databases and then click Next. In the next step, you have to select the operation which you want to perform on your pluggable database. As in our case, we want to create a new pluggable database, thus we will go with the first option which is create a pluggable database. Select the first option and click next. In the third step, you have to choose the container database in which you want to create your pluggable database. In my case, I have only one container database which is ORCL. So I will go with this one only which is already selected. Okay, click next and move ahead. Fourth step is the most important one because here we will install all our sample schemas in our pluggable database. In normal case, we select the first option and move on to the next step. But in this scenario, Oracle Engine will create a pluggable database for you but without any sample schema. Since we want to install the sample schemas in our pluggable database, thus we will select the third option which is create pluggable database using PDB file set. Choosing this option will enable both its text field, where in the first field we will have to specify the location of metadata file. The name of the metadata file is sampleschema.xml. This file comes pre-installed with the Oracle Database software, but in case you don't have this file, then check the documentation of your software. To select the metadata file, click the browse button. By default, it will open the location of templates folder. And as you can see here is our sampleschema.xml file. But in case it doesn't, then let me tell you where you can find this template folder, which has our sampleschema.xml metadata file. For that, first I have to zoom out a little bit and here we go. Now, first go to your Oracle home directory. And here I am. Right now, I am in my dbhome_1 directory, which is my Oracle home. In your case, it may be different. Now, next, you have to go to the assistance directory. And inside the assistance directory, go to the dbca directory. And as you can see, this DBCA directory has a templates folder which has the metadata file sampleschema.xml. Let me show you. And here it is. Now you know the location of your metadata file and can easily navigate to it. So let's get back to our DBCA window. Let me set the zoom before moving ahead. I think now it's okay. Nicely focused and clearly visible. Now here select sampleschema.xml and hit OK. As you can see, software has automatically filled the location of data file backup. If it doesn't, then choose sampleschema.dfp file from the same template folder. Once you are done with this, just click next and jump to the next step. Here in the fifth step, you will have to do some configuration setting for your pluggable database. Let's do it. First, I will name my pluggable database as YouTubePDB. Next is storage. If you have configured ASM, then choose ASM here and configure accordingly. But I will let it be on file system. In the database location field, you have to give the location where Oracle can create and save files such as data file, log file, and so on and so forth. I will again let it be on default. But if you want, you can change it and give a location of your choice. Next is PDB user, where you can create an administrative user for your PDB. Through this user, you can administer your PDB. Let me quickly make a PDB admin user. Next, let this lock all existing PDB user unchecked. Now hit next and move ahead. Here you can see the summary. Next you have to hit the finish button. Doing so will start the creation of PDB along with the installation of our sample schema. Once this installation is finished, we will have to do the further configuration. This will gonna take some time, thus I will fast forward this process. Okay, creation of pluggable database is done. Hit OK and then hit close. Now let's quickly check whether our pluggable database is created or not. For that, we have to log on to our database using sysuser. Here I am. Now let's query v$pdbs view to check the existence of our pluggable database. As you can see, we have our pluggable database created and it's open for read and write operations. Next, we have to update the tnsneem.aura file and add a TNS service entry in it for our pluggable database YouTube PDB. First, open your tnsneem.aura file. For that, you have to go to your Oracle home. Here I am. Now go to the network folder and next go to the admin folder. Here is our tnsneem.aura file. Open this file with any editor of your choice. Next, to make a TNS entry, copy this whole ORCL block and paste it at the end of the file. Now change the name of this block from ORCL to YouTube PDB, which is the name of our pluggable database. And also change the value of this service underscore name tag from ORCL to YouTube PDB. Save and close this file. As we just changed the listener settings, so to make them active, we have to reload the listener. Open your command prompt with administrative privilege. Okay, here write. Everything is done. Now the only step which remains left is to unlock the users or say sample schemas. For that, we need to log on to our pluggable database using sysuser. To log on to the specific pluggable database, which is YouTube PDB in our case, we have to specify the name of the TNS service while executing connection command using @sign. Let me show you how. Here in this connection command, I have specified the name of my TNS service which we just created in tnsname.aura file using @sign right after the username and password of my sys user. Let's hit enter and connect to the database. Here we are. Let me clear the screen for you first. Now I will unlock the HR, SH and OE sample schemas using alter user DDL command. HR account is unlocked. Let's unlock other accounts also. SH account unlock. OE also unlocked. Similarly, you can unlock other sample users also. Let's confirm whether we have successfully unlocked these accounts or not by logging on to the database using all these accounts one by one. Connected. Let me quickly show you the user. User is HR, which means user HR is successfully unlocked. Now let's check SH user. Connected. As you can see, the user is SH, which means SH is also unlocked. OE also connected. Let me quickly show you the user also. User is OE, which means OE is also successfully unlocked. So guys, that's how we install sample schema or say sample users in Oracle Database 12c. I have also done a video on how to unlock HR user in Oracle 12c. You can also watch that tutorial. The link is in the description box. You can also check my blog on the same topic for more in-depth knowledge. Again, all the links are in the description box. With this, I will wind up today's tutorial on how to install sample schemas in Oracle Database 12c, or should I say how to create pluggable database with sample schema in Oracle Database 12c. Hope you have learned something and enjoyed watching. Please tell me how you like this video. For that, you can either leave me a comment or write me a tweet @RebellionRider. And if you like this video, then please hit the thumbs up button. Also, don't forget to hit that big red button and subscribe to my channel. We'll see you soon with another hot and crispy Oracle Database tutorial. Till then, take care. This is Manish from Rebellion Rider.